Okay, I have to do that every time I say the word zombies. I don't know why. It's just something I have to do. And anti-slavery society, leave them be. I want to make sure I'm supporting any kind of anti-slavery movement as much as possible. I am very much not into that. And yeah. Anyway, so anyways, guys, last episode, as you guys commonly know, we took Texas. We're about to take Colorado, and we're about to take the Oklahomans from the Mexicans and basically claim this entire border. Yeah, and basically the zombie apocalypse has broken out mostly in South America. I haven't seen too much happen yet in... Well, actually, there is a couple things happening in Europe, but there isn't too much, so... I wouldn't say the Monroe Doctrine is finite yet in terms of that step to take over the world. In China, I'm probably going to have the Monroe Doctrine enabled because that's just... Yeah... They're going to be taken over. So, anyways, back to our little situation over here on America. Oh gosh, I completely forgot one army. That's kind of weird. What we will be doing is combining all of our army into one rebel scum. Rebel scum. Rebel scum. Okay, is this rebel scum? Okay, do we have any more of these? More crusaders, rebel scum. Okay, what the? We're gonna do this for every single state, really. And apparently one of my things is going out, so I'm gonna have to get that down. Okay, there we go. It should be, yeah, there we go. That should be getting power now. Rebel scum again. Oh gosh, please tell me that's the last rebel scum, and liberal agitation will be moved from New Orleans. That's good. New Orleans should not hate us. Seriously, it should not. And then over here, no, it's over here that they want to fight us. No, it's over, where is this? Michigan. Oh shoot, Michigan's not a state? Huh, okay. Welcome Michigan to our mightyhood of statehood in the United States of America, where we do not say you get to do slavery. There we go. Alright, let's get on to this. The Euthyniums in America, the right of the numerous sects within the Protestant Christianity USA in the early 19th century, would create an environment for further theological speculation. One of the most influential movements to rise from this would be American Unitarianism, emphasizing the role of reason and understanding theology and thus rejecting the concept of the Trinity and the inherent goodliness of humanity. Its capabilities for improvements between a reason. Unitarianism would become very influential among middle and upper class populations in the northern USA and encourage several movements of social improvements from public education to abolitionism. So faith and reason can be reconciled to improve humanity during a zombie apocalypse, no less. So, anyways, Colorado, let's see, I reached that pretty quickly. Seems like Mexico's going to try to fight me a little bit. I don't think they're going to succeed, so that shouldn't be too much of a problem. And I'm going to divide my armies right now, and I'm going to go send half of my armies to go group up, and we're going to go send them on a little side spree to go protect the USCA, because we want to make sure that they are protected at all costs, because that's where we're drawing the... Oh, shoot. Yep. Time to go. Time to go put my soldiers out there. The Monroe Doctrine specifically said we have to protect against all little states. But this is on a whole new level. We have to protect against zombie apocalypse stuff. So, yeah. On a whole new level now. Let's see. We'll keep building new stuff. That's good. In terms of what our country looks like in railroads. We haven't built that many railroads yet. As I let the rich slowly... be rich. We should have a really good economy set up. I mean, we should. I mean, to the knights, I'm not doing the southern labor. Leave them be. Let the anti-slavery society work. And apparently, I have a couple events, so I can do the whole gauge rule, which is a seemingly, what does it do? Because I don't feel like reading that. Okay, and I could do the Kansas-Nebraska Act. I'm not going to enact the Kansas-Nebraska Act. No way, no how. I'm going to enact this, because that could be pretty good for me. And there we go, get my soldiers onto the boats. Oh gosh. Let's see. Oh, I'm not going, doy. Okay, blast. Okay, he's a reasonable man. Okay, construction engineer, now that I got that. Now, let's see. I'm moving on to medicine. Medicine, so I can get combat medicine. And then we're gonna move you guys right over here next to the coast. And USCA, give me military access. Thank you, thank you. And we're going to put you guys right on the coast, right here in Leon. And we're basically just going to protect ourselves. Rebel scum! Oh, gosh. I hope they're about done with that, with the cores of the CSA, because I really don't want to get every single core. And over here, got this to be a state before they did, I think. Yes. Create a protectorate. Yeha! I beat you guys to it. Okay. And there we go. Create a protectorate. There we go. We won that. We won both the colonizational games. And apparently, this is a slave state. That's not good. That is seriously not good. Hopefully we can get that rectified in a coming future. I do not like the idea of the slave states coming. Alright. Apparently there's only 6k moving in right now to go try to take over the central United States. But I'm going to have 22,000 men over here to make sure that we protect this border. Because this border is essential to our survival. Okay. Right now we're doing pretty good in terms of taxes. A higher tax is just a little bit in terms of administration power. Just by one. I'm just gonna hire by one. And we're going up just by slightly. And abolition parliaments, we definitely need more abolitionists. And the benevolent empire. Oh goodness, no. One direct impact of the religious revival in the United States in the early 19th century would be the explosion in the number of voluntary organizations organized to help improve society by selflessly conquering all the uncolonized lands after the world has already ended and we didn't do anything to help them. That's what I'm going to sum this up as, for the betterment of our society. Yeah! Oh gosh. That event right there, that was one of those events I was looking at when I was going through this originally, being like, yeah, I'm gonna get a laugh out of that. Okay, and the Moral Crusaders, I'm just gonna say wickedness must be stamped out, okay. And the president, the initial crises, they're not involved with me. And how is the rest of, oh shoot, Mexico, don't you dare tell me you already have... Oh, no, I'm not ready for this. I'm not ready for you guys. You guys are supposed to be able to handle your guys as rebels. Texas exists. Okay. Have invented romantic... Oh, gosh, dang it. I won't be able to get Manifest Destiny for a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna have to hope... Okay, I'm gonna have to go put my men over here and see what the situation is like in Mexico. And I know they don't like me... to see if I really do have to come in and go step them out. Because if they don't get this under control, we could potentially deal with an entire horde moving up from Mexico to go destroy us. Because we don't, like I said, we don't have enough army to actually control the entire, you know, if one country like either Canada or Mexico have an entire zombie population breakout, we would not be able to handle it. But if we could control the zombie movement down here, we could definitely starve out most of it. Alright, we cannot see what's happening. Are they conquering anything else? It looks like no, and it looks like the Mexican government has it under control. Okay, good. Good thing too, that almost gave me a heart attack right there, seriously. Okay, and... Alright, I'm gonna take like a couple breathers, because I think we got the situation under control. I got most of the land I need for right now, which is good, which is very good. And, you know, sooner or later, these places will all become states, which will be pretty nice. And, yeah, must be stamped out, good thing. And we're keeping our revolt risk pretty low, right? Except for a couple regions that I'm guessing are because of idiocy. I'm probably gonna have to go send my men over here. Let's go send our men over there. And there we go. Alright. We're all good. We are all good in the zombie apocalypse. I should also be worrying about my economy just a little bit. I'm increasing this one right here so it can, Manhattan, Massachusetts to have a little bit to grow. I can't actually do anything right now. I can only invest in stuff that I like. Like, I like this, and I like this. I like railroads. Railroads are a definite good thing. If capitalists can start gaining in on the railroads, we'd have a joyous system. Saxony goes bankrupt. All these places are starting to fall to the... onslaught of the zombie apocalypse. Let's see, how is Europe doing? Europe is dead! I mean, seriously, Europe is now completely swarmed by zombies. Even two Sicilies fell. Greece is actually still alive, and so is the Ottomans. That's pretty cool, but the Ottomans are gonna get ripped apart by two different hordes. One from the east and one from the west. They're not gonna be able to stave off both. Oh gosh, and Egypt is gonna fall, seems like Ethiopia is gonna fall, seems like Africa's most of its colonies are gonna fall, except for this one over here with Portugal. And the Santos seem to be just chilling out there in their little African state, not doing anything, just being glad they're not next to anyone important. Because otherwise they'd probably die. Over here we have the zombies slowly starting to move closer and closer to our neighbors. We have our soldiers there instantly though, so we shouldn't have too much trouble if things were to go awry. So anyways, we're also going to have to, seems like we're going to have to tax people a little bit more. Not necessarily the best thing to do, especially for the American people. We do not like taxes. And yeah, there we go. We are the second power in the game, people. Without really doing anything, we are the second power in the game. And my economy is starting to really bug me. I'm going to have to really think about, do I want tariffs? I don't want tariffs, but I don't think we can go anywhere else without it. Let's try to maybe lower taxes, maybe that will help. Leave it be? Yeah, let's leave it be. Blast! Oh no, it's the Jacobsons! Oh, my mortal enemy of any rebellion! They are like the one hated... Yeah, if you guys don't know, I hate the Jacobsons. They are like my worst enemy in this game. Okay, let's go ahead, tariff our people by... 6%. We're gonna have to tariff our people by 6% to get us out of this funk we're right now in. And we got a quick economy recovery, and now we're back into zero. That's really nice. And apparently Montana is gonna be joining the US of A. Wait, that's not Montana. That's Montana! Let's join the coalition! Yay! You guys are not gonna be safe. Okay? And the Trail of Tears. Do I enact the Trail of Tears? See, this event would be so nice to have, but morally, this is a really wrong event. Do I enact it? No. I'm going to be better than actual America was in our time. I will not enact the Trail of Tears. The Indians will not be moved from their lands. They will stay where they are. They just better not cause any uprisings. That's the only thing I do not request. And the 15,000 army right there, standing right there waiting to kill me. That is not a good sign. And my economy is just not wanting to cooperate right now. It is like, yep, no, no. Well, let's see. I think it's because some of my subsidizing. Okay, let's stop subsidizing the lumber mill. Lumber mill seems like I don't have to subsidize the lumber mill. The lumber mill can fail. Because it doesn't seem to be making me any money. Yeah, that's way too... Just decrease it. That's just way too much of my hard-earned money that's sacrificing. Alright, now that I have that out of the way, we can actually decrease taxes back to 12 and lower tariffs by a little bit. So now tariffs are only 4%. There we go. We got the economy back underway. Blast it! Hate the Jacobsons. Alright, let's see how the... Okay, so let's see. How's the world doing? The colonist rallies. Good job, guys. We're in a zombie apocalypse and you guys want to dethrone the government that is keeping you guys safe at night. Good job. All men were created equal. The truest statement right there. Secret society, whatever. Alright, and let's see. Is this being conquered? No, it seems like... Okay, so England seems like it's going to survive. It seems like a couple states are going to survive. And now that I have that, now I'm going to go to culture, and now I'm going to get idealism. That way I can tech up a little bit faster. And I'll start getting the last little bit so I can just start colonizing all over the place once the world ends. Which it should start to end here very, very soon. Rebel scum, and holy shit, I wasn't paying attention. Go! Go, my man, I wasn't paying attention! There we go, okay, we crushed him pretty easily. Because these are only South American rebels, so they won't be that harmful to our country. Alright, and we stopped him from ever spawning any more people. And yes, we stopped the zombie horde right there and there. And I feel happy right now, guys. I can kind of calm down a little bit, except for the Jacobsons just causing more and more trouble in my country. Thanks a lot. I mean, how much is my revolt risk? Oh my gosh, dang it. I'm really hoping there are no zombies. Oh well, I wonder why it's the slaves in those states. Of course they'd be very rebellious. Jacobson rebels. They're a problem though. How much are the Jacobsons gaining? Well, it doesn't seem like there's any... They don't seem to be gaining anything. That is good. And abolitionist movement, I'm not going to de-support that. Suffrage movement, I may have to de-support that because I don't want my people to vote. Are you kidding me? This is America. You don't get to vote. And the Jacobson's uprising and the Moor Crusaders, and I think we got most of this side of the world intact. Without the rebels from over here coming up and trying to destroy us, we basically got the world underneath our control. This is sweet, guys. I mean, we could definitely create a new empire from this. And it looks like the old world is collapsing while the new world is healthy and arising anew. So Florida wants to join our statehood. Yeah! Okay. Do you guys get states? You guys get slavery? Ah, no! You guys should already know the answer to this. Do you guys get slavery? No! Yeah, I'm not giving you guys, I'm not giving anyone slavery if I can manage it. So, let me see. How many of my states actually do support slavery? It's way less than the South actually had in American history. I think the only places are Arkansas. I know these guys. Does Tennessee have slavery? Yes, they do. Kentucky has slavery. That's not good. Kentucky, I can't get rid of these places. So, this is, if I really honestly say, this would be the South. Not a very powerful South, so we'd be able to, if they were to rise up and fight us, which they will do no matter what, we'll be able to fight that. Rebel faction organizing the American reactionaries, as long as it's not the Zombies faction, we are good. Okay, 29, 30, 31, oh gosh, why am I having so many lag problems right now? Probably because I've been recording for a little bit, but I'll go a little bit longer to keep in cruise. Leave it be, let's just go a little bit slower. There we go. Now it's going fast again. I think it's because there's so much happening right now in the world because of, like, rebel scum, because of, like, all this world collapsing. I think that's why it's having a little bit of difficulty keeping up. So let's just go, like, 3? Can we go 3? Yeah, we can go 3. So it's not like we can't go really fast, it's just the rebels are starting to come into the country. Block them up. There we go, we instantly stop them. And they're all dead. 3,000 zombies instantly killed by my elite guard. Now, I really wish the CSA would also have its army right here at San Jose. That way we could both, you know, simultaneously block up any zombies that would come. But sadly, that will not happen. And the essays! Randolph Waldo Emerson's first collection of essays was published in 1841 and introduced the world to a new, rather mythological philosophy indigenous to the New World. Although many Europeans didn't consider his much of a philosopher per se, his influence of continental thinking was unmistakable, most significantly on Inzuzak. I can't say that. A little bit else about Emerson, he was also the guy who started transcendentalism. Pretty cool guy, I would say. What can we do? Outlaw slavery. Let's just get that done with. Alright. And the South rises up? No? What? Wait, did I just beat the system? Did I literally just get past the point where I... What? Wait, where's the big southern uprising? What? Really? I just got away with getting... with, like, outlawing slavery and no one said anything? No one gave a peep? Wow, I love this America! Things are just coming up Millhouse, guys! That's all I gotta say. Alright. Seems like we have Colorado about to join statehood. You guys. We no longer have the event to create slave states, which is such a joyous event. So Colorado is now just gonna be admitted as a free state. And that's gonna be the joyous thing ever. Oh gosh. And let's see, craftsmen, everything. We're doing good. We're doing fairly good right now. Probably need to increase this. The winery production's doing pretty well. You know what? Let's detach all of our original stuff. I mean, I can keep this. I'm keeping the steel mill. I'm just not going to get rid of the steel mill. We can increase the steel mill. But I think we could probably decrease everything else. And I'm going to slow down time a little bit more. It seems like it's just lagging up on all cylinders. So, I think I'll call this an episode, guys. So, thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this Let's Play. Hope you guys are good. Comment, rate, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.